Hi, welcome to Robojax. In this video, I'm going to introduce this LM1637 display. So this is a device that you can use easily with Arduino, so it can show some kind of counter or display, let's say a number like this, or maybe you just want to display a counter, something like this, up to 500, and then start over again. So it can be used in many ways and applications. It's very easy to use, so let me explain how it works. So it has four pins, VCC, ground. So these two pins, the last one is ground, this is VCC. And then we have data input and then clock. So in our case, I'm just connecting it to Arduino here to pin, as you can see here, to 5 volts and to the ground, this red and black one. So VCC is connected here and then ground, and then the data will be connected for the data pin will be connected to pin 3, and the clock will be connected to pin 2. So the code will be displayed now here. Okay, so to get the code, the link is provided in the description, so you go to this address. Once you click, it's at GitHub TM1637. Just click on this clone or download and download it. So once you click and save, then go to the folder. I'm using Chrome, so I'm going to the show folder. So this is the file here. Now one way would be to just right click 7-zip. 7-zip can be downloaded for free, so extract here. Once you do that, you will have this folder, TM1637 master. So this is a folder with all example and codes. So you copy, right click, copy it, and then go to your Arduino folder. In my case, I've installed the Arduino without any installation. I've just downloaded and it's running. It's called Portable. So go to the library. So this is the Arduino that I run. Go to the library and somewhere in the clean spot, right click, paste, and this folder will be here. That part is done. Now just run your Arduino and open it. So then go to the file, examples, and scroll down until you see TM1637 master and test. So this is the file that you will open and work with. Let me explain some portion of the code, because there are so many things and we don't need to know it to make it work, because this code has, so the only important pin is the clock pin is defined at pin 2. Unless you use your Arduino for other purpose, I would suggest just keep it as 2 and then data. So make it as pin 3. So that's it. The rest of this code are example of different feature of this Arduino. So let me run the code and you will see it. I'm just uploading the code. This is a old code that was running, so just wait for it. Code have been uploaded. The first thing that it does, it prints all the displays like that. So it sends all the data. After that, it prints this random values. So here it starts from 1 to 7. And then all those multiple of 7 with some values that you see here, this is the one. After that, it goes from 0 to 3 and displays 4 smaller number. So these are the values. And then you will see that you see all those numbers. And then it sets it to 0, including the decimal point. So then here is 153 and then 22 that you see on the screen, 0 and all those numbers, and then the brightness. Now it tests the brightness here. You see? After that, it goes to on off. This code is for on off. So on and off to about, and then it prints done, D-O-N-E. You will see the text here. So done. Once it's done, while equal one, that means infinite loop, so it stays here forever until you unplug the power of Arduino. Until you unplug this, it stays there with the done. So because it does so many other things, so for many options, I will just go and explain the simplest way that I have tried. You see the master file that we downloaded is required now here. So you have to have this one, otherwise you'll get error. The instruction that I gave you to put the files in the folder will include this, and that issue will be resolved. So you don't worry. So pin 2 is a clock, pin 3 is a data. So you accordingly set it, because here the data and clock are set for those values. So this clock is now connected to pin 2. And then the data is connected to pin 3 because we set it here. After that, this 2000 millisecond is a delay between some actions that we use here. I will explain it. Then this is the defining the display object, but don't worry about it. So you don't touch this as well. Inside the setup, we don't have anything, so you don't touch these. And here this K is from the main original code. So first we are setting the brightness of the display at the maximum. So every time the loop runs, it will be at the maximum, because we can set the display brightness from this value, this F mean maximum. Okay, so it can be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9, and then A, B, C, D, and F. So that will be the maximum. And then we set the display. Now let me explain how this works. So this is setting the brightness. So you leave that for the maximum brightness, that F is the maximum, because it starts from 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 9, and then A, B, C, D up to F. So to set the screen with a blank, so these are the values for each digit. So first digit, second, third, fourth, 0x mean that's hex value, and this is 0 mean actual value. So we are setting 0, and then say set segment with this data. The data comes here. So don't worry about it. These two line makes the screen blank. Simple as that. Otherwise, the previous value will stay there. Now, this one is show number this. So decimal. So this is actual value, readable, human readable value, if you want to send, let's say, if you want to send 23. So we say 23, put false here. And then this false is supposed to work with a digits 0 on the left side to display it. And then we have 2. 2 means this parameter is number of digits. So if we have 2 digits, put this 2. If we have 1 digit, we put 1. And then this 2 means start from the position from left. So 0, 1, 2, 3. So this means if we say 0, it will print 23 here, 2 and 3. So let me do it. So you see 23 starts from here. And after that, I'm blanking it here. This line, the job of this line is to blank it. Let me just comment this out and then send you, so you will see that 23 stays there, and then 153 will be printed on top of it. So now look, 23 and then 153, because 2 is there, you see. 153. So you have to clear the screen if you are printing something else after one thing, something else. So now if I set this to 3, however, make sure to understand it, that 0, 1, 2, 3. So this is the fourth digit, is number 3. So it's 23 starts from 2 here and then 3. So the 3 is out of the screen. So So make sure that you understand that this one should be accordingly. If you have one digit, this will work. If you have two digits, it should be smaller. So the number 0, 1, 2, 3, so you see the 3 starts from here. So make sure that you understand it. And for 153, because this is 3 digits, we put 3 and then we say start from 1, it starts from here. If we put it 1, it will be 1, 0. If this parameter is set as 0, this 153 will start here. So now let me show you how you can just put a counter. I wrote a code here. Simple, it just writes from 0 to 500. So I'm clearing the screen first. So this one is a loop. It says I from 0, I smaller than 500, and then just whatever is the I becomes 0, 1, 2, 3, up to 500. So it prints that, print 153, and then it goes here up to 500. When it reaches 500, the loop goes back, it writes 23. So when this loop finishes, it goes back here and starts again, setting the maximum brightness, setting it with the data for the blank, and that's it. So out of after 153, again we can go. So this can go up to 9999 because the maximum in 4 digits. So you can use this in distance measurement and some kind of counter. Let's say there are equipment on door or number of movement of stuff, or with a gesture sensor, or even if you work a little hard, you can even make a clock here. So I might have, I might make some clock, and the code will be posted. But for now, all this code and examples will be posted by clicking at the description, the link at the description. And or maybe you can go directly to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. So thank you for watching. Please thumb up the video, and also please subscribe to get updates of my upcoming videos.